While we get the stage set up for our next and last and final panel discussion for the day, a quick shout out for those of you who are interested in buying the merchandise from the store outside. It's all about poetry, so feel free to pick up a merchandise for yourself. As you know, the Bengaluru Poetry Festival is completely community-driven, so any contributions in that respect will be highly appreciated. All right, we're almost set up. In the previous section, Sampoorna Chatterjee, when she was speaking about when she was reciting one of the poems, she spoke about how poets name the unnameable and speak the unspeakable. That's a great segue into our next panel, which is The Poet and the Patriot. What happens when poetry meets politics? And on this interesting panel, I have the pleasure of inviting some great poets. We'll start with Hoshang Merchant joining us after his great session yesterday. Mondakrantha Sen, Pratibha Nandakumar, Sarabjot Bale, Sandeep Bhutoria, T.P. Rajivan, and moderating this session will be Huma Mirza. Can we have a huge round of applause? This is our last and final panel discussion at the Bengaluru Poetry Festival 2019. We're poets representing multiple ideologies, multiple languages from various places. Thank you. Do we need more chairs? Okay, with that, over to you, Huma.
Adab, and good evening, everyone. Though poetry is beyond logic, but as we have arrived at the grand finale of Bangalore Poetry Festival, it seems quite logical to conclude the celebration with a round of patriotic poetry, as we are just 3 weeks short of Independence Day. We have an entire galaxy of poets who are going to share their sentiments with us, and we are going to enjoy and listen to their sentiments about patriotism, about the love of their country, howsoever they want to express it in their own ways. So the need for patriotism is paramount in every age and every time. Sometimes it takes up the context of revolution, freedom from an oppressive regime, and sometimes it deals with changing the existing obsolete ideologies, the existing in the mindsets of people. Sometimes it is just a dire need to bring an overall change in around us. So whatever in all its facets, it has the potential to benefit our country directly or indirectly. So before we begin with the contemporary ideas and contemporary poets, let us not forget to remember the legendary poets who inspired an entire generation of youth towards freedom struggle, towards fighting for the country, and evoked revolutionary sentiments amongst the people of our country. So right from Rabindranath Tagore's Vision of India in his Where the Mind is Without Fear, we have Harivansh Rai Bachchan's Azadi Ka Geet, where he beautifully depicts India, which has recently won its freedom and is looking for a bright and hopeful future. We have this lovely, brilliant Hindi kavita, Pushp Ki Abhilasha, by Makhanlal Chaturvedi, which brilliantly portrays the sentiment of a freedom fighter with flower as a mouthpiece. So then we have this Jhanda Uncha Rahe Hamara, this lovely poem by Shyamal Gupta, that eternal tricolor song, where he immortalized the tricolor much before it became the symbol of the largest democracy in the world. So we have, and amongst these poems, we have this Urdu nazm, Sarfaroshi ki tamanna ab hamare dil mein hai, dekhna hai zor kitna bazoo-e qatil mein hai, by the legendary Arya Samaji Ram Prasad Bismil. And this poem assumes greater significance in the light of the fact that Bismil was executed at the age of 30 by the British. Little did the British know that he left his spirit in his words, which continued to inspire an entire generation of youth, which includes Bhagat Singh and his comrades. So we have lovely nazms by Sarojini Naidu, lovely verses by Sarojini Naidu, and we have this Saare Jahan Se Achha by Allama Iqbal, and then we have this Vande Mataram by Bankim Chatterjee, and then last but not the least, this term Inqilab Zindabad by the maverick poet and freedom fighter Hasrat Mohani, so which is no less poetic. So we have an we can now start off with the contemporary ideas of patriotism. And I would like to first invite Mr. Hoshang Merchant, who is right here amongst us, who doesn't need an introduction though, but he has written 20 books of poetry and 4 critical studies. He's edited India's first gay anthology, Yarana, Gay Writings from India. He has lived in and taught in the various universities of United States, Heidelberg, Iran, and Jerusalem. So I would like you to please come on stage and recite.
Thank you. I hope you don't mind. I'll read a longish poem since we are sharing 1 hour between many poets, and go and sit in the audience because it's a long day for me. I'm 72 years old and I've been going at a very fast pace for the last 2 days. So please bear with me. I'll read a longish poem and I'll leave. Ashes of Gandhi. This is a poem that I have kind of worked around the ashes of Gramsci by Pier Paolo Pasolini, who is my Italian hero. Young man in that May, when to air meant one was still alive, in that Indian May, which at least gave life fire. It isn't May like this impure air, which darkens the foreigner's dark garden still more, then dazzles it with blinding sunlight. This foam-streaked sky above the other roof terraces, which in vast semicircles veil the Yamuna's curve and Aravali's cobalt mountains. Inside the ancient walls, the autumnal October diffuses a deathly peace, disquieting like our destinies, and holds the world's dismay. The finish of the decade that saw the profound knife struggle to make life over collapse in ruins, silence, humid, fruitless. You, father of the nation, take me by your thin hand, trembling like a brother ascetic, sex denying, dead like this, like us in this garden, belonging to the nation and belonging to no one. The nation too belonging to no one, despoiled by the rich. And I reach out in this fetid Indian summer from Pali Hill to the dirty tenements of Bombay along the Parel rail tracks, sad in their squalor, yet alive with their Alexandrian sex, and hear the tintinnabulation of the workshops of Trastevere and of Konya. The eye is attuned to filth, the ear to music, as on your grave waves a strand of sad homespun left there by some Italian virgin who became an Indian widow. You take all with you, the Hindu, as the dust stirs among the first big raindrops on dry, dry earth. My Arabian Nights dream. Icarus could fall into the Tyrrhenian Sea tonight. Indra descend again to walk amongst the common folk, who dozed like the autowala with a swollen sex in his auto rickshaw. Morning is far away with us. Its salt taste, with its morning is far away with a salt taste of defeated sex and with the sad frenzy of orgasmic animals who only know daily work. The workmen sleep on pavements and the schismatics sharpen the knives to cut again an already cut nation. As you sleep, you must know how I loathe the bourgeois mob I sing to, who stare and stare at me as I sing, one of them their history, as one who knows them only too well, and you, your ashes I approach between hope and distrust, where the vast river melts into the sky, and I cry out, Shelley, and with patrician grace you sing, lead kindly light. one by one the lights go on. The green dome first lit my Parsi dread. We are in Harun al-Rashid's Baghdad. And then with Damascene grace, which is not obscene, the young louts plan night adventures, conscienceless as only the young can be. The neem weeps, everything is enveloped in the stench of your blood and of poverty. And I, who can only live in history, will I ever again be able to act with pure passion when I know our history is over?
That was brilliant, Mr. Merchant.
I am brilliant.
Yes, you are. Now I would request Mr. T.P. Rajivan, a Malayali English poet, Malayali and English poet, fiction writer with 13 books to his credit, and he also writes screenplays for movies and
thank you. I'm not aware of what is the structure of this session, whether to read poems or, you know, speak about the topic that is the poet and the patriot. But I have to say that I must say that I'm not a patriot. I don't subscribe to any idea of nation, state, or anything. That is not for us. The state is not for us. The politics is not for us. And that is for some people who handles power, and I'm not with them. The position of a poet is always in the opposition bench, I believe. It is always in the north, not in the ruling bench. And if somebody says that, pretends that, or declares that he is a patriot, or, you know, he writes for the nation to survive the cultures like that, I don't believe him. It is just that he has some ulterior motive behind it, always. So, with this brief introduction, I think that you have, I won't take too much time. I read the first poem, that is The Sea Bridge. The Sea Bridge. The night before he was shot dead, while asleep, Gandhi saw Kasturba. They were in a third-class compartment on a Porbandar-bound train, going back home after winding up the last satyagraha. Both fell asleep, Gandhi thinking of the Ramarajya and Kasturba figuring on what to do getting home late. In the meantime, they didn't know that days had passed. The train stopped at several stations. Patel, Nehru, Azad, Kripalani, Abba, Manu, Sarojini Naidu, Rajagopalachari had got off one by one. And they were left alone in the compartment, in the coach, in the train. The train, taking a turn, hesitantly chugged onto a bridge, shaken. Both opened their eyes and wondered if it was the Ganga, the Yamuna, the Vaigai, Mahanadi, or the Narmada below. Putting aside the charka that was spinning even in his thoughts, Gandhi held Kasturba closer. She felt those hands would catch fire if touched. How long since we sat like this? Kasturba said. True. But a whole nation has been watching us, hasn't it? Said Gandhi. I wish we had met only while asleep. Then you are not the Mahatma, nor I the Mahatma's wife. Kasturba's eyes were wet. True. Freedom is when we picture what we desire while asleep, said Gandhi. Then, what about the freedom we have gained? Asked Kasturba. Looking out to the shore that was receding in distance, faster than the train running silently along the bridge, which didn't have pillars, over a vast sea which seemed like a river till then, Gandhi kissed the crown of Kasturba's head. So that is the sea bridge. One more poem, that is Lessons of Nature. Lessons of Nature. No mention of rivers in the constitution, so one can kill them by all means. The ones flowing untamable, depths unfathomable. No citizenship for trees in any nation, so one can uproot them from any soil. The ones probing into the other side of the earth and searching towards the sun. Lakes, they do not know the names of the largest desert, nor the pre-hour velocity of darkness. So one can fail them in all examinations, the ones containing ways within silent. Mountains, when they see an emperor can prostrate before him. So one can chain them till the end of the world, the ones who stand alone and understand the meaning of the sky. Waterfalls, they never follow rules and regulations. So one can always denounce them, the one who plunge into adventures and turn their fall into strength. Thunder, lightning, and rain, they have no organizations, no leaders. So one can shut the door forever on those who make startling appearances. So with this, I conclude my reading. And I believe only in individuals, not in citizens. I believe also that poetry is the expression of the individuals, not the citizens. Citizens never write poetry. So thank you.
That was brilliant, Mr. Rajivan. As we know that there are always two schools of poetry that has existed regarding such concerns, including the patriotic concern, and both ways have proved to be effective in their own way. One is loud journalistic style of poetry, which is more direct, which addresses the common man, sermonizing, preaching, and driving him towards a goal. The other is more mellifluous, more aesthetic, more symbolic kind of poetry, which proves to be more enduring in the long run and which trusts the higher intelligence of a man, and that he will be able to read beneath the lines and will be able to act upon it in more subtle and milder ways. So I think yours is the second, the symbolic style, which is definitely much more beautiful. Lovely it was. And now I would invite for the mess up. So this is Miss Pratibha Nandkumar. She's a poet, a journalist, a filmmaker, and she's from Bangalore. She writes in English and Kannada. She has 22 books to her credit, and which includes poetry, prose, and many translations.
The current times of dissent, I believe all arts is political. So all poetry is political, and anything that is political has to have a shade of patriotism. Otherwise, unless you have the dissent to add to what Rajivan said. So I'm going to read three English poems and three Kannada poems and try to finish it in the time that is given to me, so I'm not talking too much about it. I was born with several diseases. I was born with several diseases and thought that was the normal way. I played the flute with lips that bled at every hole, and the violin where the fingers came away. My feet crushed to a pulp while I danced, while Michael sang blood on the dance floor. I was hard of hearing as the pus oozed out, even as I wore the heavy diamonds and rubies. The exotic silks that I wore were bandages to my body, and as I opened up my thighs, I died a million deaths and survived thinking, this is life and this is heaven and this is the true bliss of being a woman. The second one is, there was an incident here when a Hindu boy and a Muslim girl eloped and they got married and went into hiding. Their families hunted them down and killed them both in front of their one-year-old child. No one wanted the child and the police took her into their custody. Honor killing. They had covered only half the distance. The mosque was on top of the hill and the temple on the other side of the cliff. The story ended even before it started. What do you tell the little one that once upon a time, a foolish man and a queen and the queen of sins were butchered for giving birth to her? Do not dare peep into the little one's eyes. You cannot answer the questions in them. Leave it to the National Geographic to capture the blue-green light in them. God incarnates and sometimes takes the form of knives and swords. Two, if honor killing is sacred, then we are a very religious country. If you say you have the answer and ask, what is the question? You will be hanged. The blood dries to make black stains on the roads where once we played hopscotch. You can live here only if you are dead. I am appalled that there is still love in my poems. Three, the sacred Brahmin who stepped on the dirt died of shock. Ganesha festival can also trigger a communal riot here. I apologize to the dung bug. Sorry, we are only humans. It just continued to roll the dung. Your best friend is standing behind you with a gun in hand, ready to pull the trigger. The newspapers carry the story of a displaced tribe caught stealing in the metro. The weight. The weight. The warrior makes demands first of all upon himself. This is a quote from Castaneda. Kindly wait, you're in a queue. You're not the first one to arrive, not the last two. Fall in line, be still, wait. The I Ching said, the footprints run crisscross. The mountain rests upon the earth. A large fruit is still uneaten. There is no water in the lake. One sits oppressed under a bare tree. That which is bright rises twice. Predictions are a different matter altogether. You are sincere, yet you are being obstructed. When a woman loses the curtain of her carriage, do not run after it. On the seventh day, you will get it. The way is in the middle. The middle way, how to take it? Sigil-initiated passion, its coming is sudden. It flames up, dies down, and is thrown away. It has nothing that would cause it to be accepted. If one is seriously intent, order emerges out of confusion. If benefaction is not yet seen, focus on the coming together. To feel caressed without being touched, to be bruised from a distance, to be blessed by the seeing God, there are no ulterior motives in the midst of the greatest obstructions. Conflict, it is humiliating. They say the truth of a warrior is accessible yet dignified. Acting without prearrangement, it cannot go backward, it cannot go forward. Nothing serves to further. You do not travel through the land. You have no feel of the earth. You receive him in virtue energetically. The power of the great shows itself in the fact that one pauses. He has not stirred from his red chair. Demand to draw every bit of the inner waters before you step out of line, and though dismissed, you meet with praise. Hence, fall in line, be still, wait. The master will take you in a minute. Now I want to read three Kannada poems. One is called Devi. This was written when there was an attack on girls on a pub in Mangalore. And when we protested, we asked them why they did it, and they said it is not in our culture. So I asked them, what is our culture? They didn't know. I asked them, do you know Lalita Sahasranama? Is that our culture? Oh, they were all very proud. Yes, Lalita Sahasranama. So I used all the words in the Lalita Sahasranama and wrote a poem, because the description of Devi in Lalita Sahasranama is exactly, again, is opposite of what these people say is our culture. I really hope you can understand, because it is so much of Sanskrit in it. Devi. Avalu malavillada nirmale. Avalu lolakshi kamarupini. Kamakke yogeshwari, krodhakke maheshwari, lobakke vaishnavi, madakke brahmani, mohakke swayambhu kalyani, matsaryakke indraja, paishunyakke yamadandabhadra, asuyege varahi. ದೇವಿ ಎಂದರೆ ಇಚ್ಛಾಶಕ್ತಿ, ಜ್ಞಾನಶಕ್ತಿ, ಕ್ರಿಯಾಶಕ್ತಿ ಸ್ವರೂಪಿಣಿ. ಅವಳು ರುದಿರಸ್ಥಿತ, ಮಾಂಸನಿಷ್ಠ, ಮಧುಪ್ರೀತ, ಮಾಧ್ವಿ ಪಾನಾಲಸಾಮತ್ತ, ಬಲಿಪ್ರಿಯ, ಸುಖಾರಾಧ್ಯ, ಲಾಸ್ಯಪ್ರಿಯ, ವಿಶೃಂಖಲ, ರತಿಪ್ರಿಯ, ಕಾಮಕೇಲಿ ತರಂಗಿತ. ಶಕ್ತಿ ದೇವಿಯ ಯೋಗವಿಲ್ಲದಿದ್ದರೆ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ, ವಿಷ್ಣು, ರುದ್ರ, ಈಶ್ವರ, ಸದಾಶಿವರು ಪ್ರೇತಗಳಂತೆ ನಿಶ್ಚಲರು. ಅವಳು ಅವರ ನೇರಿ ಕುಳಿತ ಪಂಚ ಪ್ರೇತಾಸನಾಸೀನ. ಅವಳು ಕಾಮೇಶಿ, ಕಾಮಿತಾರ್ಥದ, ಕಾಮ ಸಂಜೀವಿನಿ, ಕಾಮದಾಯಿನಿ. ಅವಳು ಲಬ್ಧಪತಿ, ಲಬ್ಧ ಭೋಗ, ಲಬ್ಧ ಸುಖ, ಲಬ್ಧ ಕಾಮ, ತನ್ನಿಚ್ಛೆಯಂತೆ ಪತಿ, ಭೋಗ, ಸುಖ, ಕಾಮವನ್ನು ಹೊಂದಿದವಳು. ಅವಳು ಕುಡಿಯಬಹುದು, ಕುಣಿಯಬಹುದು, ಕೇಳಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಮುಳುಗಿ ತೇಲಬಹುದು. ಹಿಡಿಯಲಾರಿರಿ ನೀವು ಅವಳನ್ನು ಪಬ್ಬುಗಳಲ್ಲಿ, ಹೊಡೆದು ಕೆಡವಿ ದಕ್ಕಿಸಿಕೊಳ್ಳಲಾರಿರಿ. ಮಬ್ಬು ಬೆಳಕಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾಣಲಾರಿರಿ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮಂಜು ಕಣ್ಣುಗಳಲ್ಲಿ. ಎದ್ದು ಬರುತ್ತಾಳೆ ನೂರು ನಾಲಿಗೆ ಚಾಚಿ ರಕ್ತ ಹೀರುತ್ತ, ಅವಳ ಬೊಗಸೆಯೊಳಗೆ ನೀವು ಆಪೋಷಣ. ಸಿಂಧೂರ ಕೇಸರಿಗೆ ಅವಳೇ ಅಧಿದೇವತೆ, ನಿಮ್ಮದೆಲ್ಲ ಬರಿ ನೀರಿಗೆ ಕರಗುವ ಗುಲಾಲು. ಗಲ್ಲಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ನುಸುಳಿ ಕಂಬದ ಮರೆಯಿಂದ ಮುಲುಗುಡುವ ನಿರ್ವೀರ್ಯರು, ಬಲ್ಲಿರೇನಯ್ಯ ಅವಳ ಹುಟ್ಟಿನ ಕುಲವ. ಪೀಠಸ್ಥೆಯನ್ನು ಅರ್ಚಿಸಿ ಭಜಿಸಿ ನೈವೇದ್ಯ ಭುಜಿಸಿ ತಿಲಕ ಧರಿಸಿ ಮಡದಿಯ ಕಾಡಿಗಟ್ಟಿದವನ ಹೆಸರಲ್ಲಿ ಕವಿದು ಬಿದ್ದರು ಹರಿಯ ಚರಣದಲ್ಲಿ ಹರನಸತಿಯ ಮರೆತು. ಕಲಿತು ಬನ್ನಿರಿ ಮೊದಲು ಕ್ಷರ ಅಕ್ಷರಗಳ, ಹ್ರಸ್ವ ದೀರ್ಘ ಒತ್ತಕ್ಷರ ಓತ್ವ ಅಲ್ಪ ಮಹಾಪ್ರಾಣಗಳ. ತೊಳೆದು ಬನ್ನಿರಿ ಕಾಲು ಕಳೆದು ಹೊರಗಿನ ಮಲಗಳ, ಎರಗಿ ನಿಲ್ಲಿರಿ ಅಲ್ಲೇ ಬಾಗಿ ಮೈಮನಗಳ. ಹೂವು ಹಣ್ಣುಗಳ ಬಿಡಿ ಕಾಯಿ ಕರ್ಪೂರವೂ ಬೇಡ, ದಕ್ಷಿಣೆಯ ತಟ್ಟೆಗೆ ಬೀಳದಿದ್ದರೂ ಝಣಝಣ ತೊದಲು ನಾಲಿಗೆಯಲ್ಲಿ, ರಾತ್ರಿಯ ಇಳಿಯದ ನಶೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಮಂತ್ರಬಾರದು ಸ್ವಸ್ತಿ ಸ್ವರಾಗವಲ್ಲ, ಅರ್ಚನೆಯ ಕುಂಕುಮ ಗಂಧವಿಲ್ಲ, ಆದರೂ ಒಲಿಯಬಹುದು ಅವಳು ನಿಮಗೆ ಹೇಳಲಾಗದು. ನಿಮ್ಮ ಎದೆಯೊಳಗೆ ಇದ್ದರೆ ಪ್ರೇಮ, ಅರಿತರೆ ನೀವು ಅವಳು ಬರಿಯ ಬೊಂಬೆಯಲ್ಲ. ಹಾಡಿದರೆ ತಾಯಿ, ಹರಸಿದರೆ ದೇವಿ, ಒಲಿದರೆ ರತಿ, ಕೆರಳಿದರೆ ಕಾಳಿ. ಇವತ್ತಿನ ಈ ಪೇಟ್ರಿಯಾಟ್ ಪೊಲಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಅಂದಿದ್ದಕ್ಕೆ ಸಿ ಗಿರೀಶ್ ಕಾರ್ನಾಡ್ ಐ ಎಮ್ ಎ ನಗರ್ ಅರ್ಬನ್ ನಕ್ಸಲ್ ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ಬೋರ್ಡ್ ಹಾಕೊಂಡು ಕೂತಿದ್ದಕ್ಕೆ ಸಿಕ್ಕಾಪಟ್ಟೆ ಟ್ರಾಲ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು. ರೈಟ್ ವಿಂಗರಂತೂ ಅವ್ರನ್ನ ದೇ ಟ್ರಾಲ್ಡ್ ಗಿರೀಶ್ ಕಾರ್ನಾಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಪುಟಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ a badge that saying that he is an urban naxal. So this was written in, and this also uses the Punyakoti fable. Adella helak time illa ivaga into in English. Ondu govu nagara naxal ada kathe. Nanna paadige nanu nanna karuvige haalu kudisi namma paadige naaviddevu. Nimma paadenu tiliyadu namage. ಗಂಗೆ ತುಂಗೆ ಗೌರಿ ಎಂದೆಲ್ಲ ಹೆಸರಿಟ್ಟು ನನ್ನ ಕೆಚ್ಚಲಿಗೆ ಕೈಯಿಕ್ಕಿ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಹಾಲಿನ ವ್ಯಸನಕ್ಕೆ ಪುಣ್ಯ ಪುರುಷಾರ್ಥದ ನೆಪ ಹೇಳಿದಿರಿ. ದನದ ಮಾಂಸದ ದಾಸರು ಜಾತಿ ಧರ್ಮಗಳ ನೆಪದಲ್ಲಿ ಸಮರ್ಥಿಸಿಕೊಂಡಿರಿ. ಚಪ್ಪಲಿ ತೊಟ್ಟುಕೊಂಡು ತಮಟೆ ನುಡಿಸಿದಿರಿ. ಖಂಡವಿದೆಕೋ ಮಾಂಸವಿದೆಕೋ ಎಂದು ಬರೆದು ಹಾಡಿದಿರಿ. ನೀನಾರಿಗಾದೆಯೋ ಎಲೆಮಾನವ ಎಂದು ನಾನು ಕೇಳಲಿಲ್ಲ, ನೀವೇ ಕೇಳಿಕೊಂಡಿರಿ. ಮತ್ತೆ ನೀವೇ ರೊಚ್ಚಿಗೆದ್ದು ಸಂಚು ಮಾಡಿ ಕೊಂದಿರಿ. ಗೋಹತ್ಯೆ ಮಹಾಪಾಪ ಅಂತಲೂ ಸಾರಿದಿರಿ, ನರಬಲಿಯನ್ನೂ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರಿ. ರಾಸು ಕಾರಣವಲ್ಲ ಕೌಬಾಯಿಗಳ ರಾಸಲೀಲೆಗೆ, ಸುಂದರಾಂಗದ ಸುಂದರಿಯರ ಹಿಂದು ಮುಂದಿನಲಿ ಎಂದು ಕೊಂಡಾಡಿದವರು ನೀವು. ನಂದಗೋಪನ ಗೋಪಿಕೆಯರ ಗೊಲಸಿನ ಸದ್ದಿಗೋ ನಮ್ಮ ಕೊರಸಿಗೋ ಅರ್ಥಾತ್ ಸಂಬಂಧವಿಲ್ಲ. ಆದರೂ ಹಾಲು ಮಾರುವ ಬಾಲಿಕೆಯರ ಸೊಂಟ ಕುಣಿಸಿದಿರಿ. ದನವ ಕಡಿ ಕಡಿದು ಬಸದಿಗೊಯ್ಯುತ್ತಿದ್ದರ್ ಎನ್ನುವ ಮಾ ಪರಮಪಾತಕ ಸಾಲಿಗೆ ಚಂದನವ ಎಂದು ತಿದ್ದಿ ಸರಿ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡಿರಿ. ಮುಂದೆ ಬಂದರೆ ಹಾಯಲಾರೆ, ಹಿಂದೆ ಬಂದರೆ ಒದೆಯಲಾರೆ ಎಂದು ನಾನು ಮಾತು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿಲ್ಲ. ಹುಲಿಯ ಬಾಯಿಗೆ ಬೀಳುವ ಕಥೆ ನನ್ನದಲ್ಲ. ನಿಮ್ಮ ನಿಮ್ಮ ತನುವ ಸಂತೈಸಿಕೊಂಡು ನಿಮ್ಮ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮನವ ನಿಯಂತ್ರಿಸಿಕೊಂಡು ಬಾಳ್ವೆ ಮಾಡಲು ಅಸಲು ಏನ್ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಮು? ಐ ಹೋಪ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಕನ್ನಡ. ಓಕೆ, ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಕನ್ನಡ ಗೊತ್ತಿರೋರಿಗೆ, ಬೆಂಗಳೂರವ್ರಿಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿರುತ್ತೆ. ವೆನ್ ಚೀಫ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಸಿದ್ದರಾಮಯ್ಯ ವೆನ್ ಟು ಧರ್ಮಸ್ಥಳ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಈಟಿಂಗ್ ಫಿಶ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ನೂನ್, ದೇರ್ ವಾಸ್ ಅ ಬಿಗ್ ಗಲಾಟ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದೇ ಥಾಟ್ ದಟ್ ಹಿ ಶುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಈಟ್ ನಾನ್ ವೆಜ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಗೋ ಟು ಅ ಟೆಂಪಲ್. ಸೊ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೇರ್ ವಾಸ್ ಅ ವೆರಿ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲರ್ ಫಿಲ್ಮ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಎದ್ದೇಳು ಮಂಜುನಾಥ. ಮಂಜುನಾಥ ಈಸ್ ದ ಗಾಡ್ ಇನ್ ಧರ್ಮಸ್ಥಳ ಟು ವಿಚ್ ಟೆಂಪಲ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸಿ ಎಮ್ ವೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ಐ ಯೂಸ್ ದ ಟೈಟಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ಫಿಲ್ಮ್ ಎದ್ದೇಳು ಮಂಜುನಾಥ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರೋಟ್ ಅ ಪೋಯಮ್ ಎದ್ದೇಳು ಮಂಜುನಾಥ. ಮೀನು ತಿಂದು ಬಂದವರೇ ಭಕ್ತರು ಎದ್ದೇಳು ಮಂಜುನಾಥ, ಹಸಿದು ಬಂದಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಮತ್ತೊಬ್ಬರು ಎದ್ದೇಳ್ತೀಯ ಮಂಜುನಾಥ. ಉಪವಾಸ ಮಾಂಸ ಖ್ಯಾತಿ ಅಪಖ್ಯಾತಿ ತಿಂದು ಕುಡಿದವರ ವ್ಯಾಖ್ಯಾನ ಪ್ರೀತಿ, ಅವರ ಪಾದಧೂಳಿಯಿಂದ ಪಾವನವಾಯಿತಂತೆ ನಿನ್ನ ದೇಗುಲ ನಿನಗೊಪ್ಪಿಗೆಯೇ ಮಂಜುನಾಥ. ತಿಂದಿರಬಾರದು ಮೀನು, ತಂದಿರಬಾರದು ಫೋನು, ತೊಟ್ಟಿರಬಾರದು ಪ್ಯಾಂಟು, ಕುಡಿದಾಗಿರಬಾರದು ಟೈಟು, ತೊಳೆ ತೊಳೆದು ಮಡಿಯಾಗಿಟ್ಟ ಗರ್ಭಗುಡಿಗೆ ಹೊಕ್ಕ ಬೇಡರ ಕಣ್ಣಪ್ಪ, ತಿನ್ನಲಾಗದು ಅವಿತು ಬಾಳೆಯ ಹಣ್ಣು, ನಾನು ಹೋದರೆ ಹೋದೇನೋ ಎಂದವನಿಗೆ ಬಿದ್ದ ಲಾಟಿ ಪೆಟ್ಟೇನೋ, ಗಂಜಲ ಕುಡಿದವರ ನಾಲಿಗೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ತಪ್ಪುತ್ತದೆಯಂತೆ ಸ್ತೋತ್ರ ತೊದಲಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ನು ನಿನ್ನ ಒಲಸಿಕೊಳ್ಳುವ ಆಸೆ ಯಾರಿಗಿಲ್ಲ ಮಂಜುನಾಥ. ಕಮಲಕ್ಕೂ ಕಮಲಹಾಸನಿಗೋ ಮಲ ಮಾತ್ರವೇ ಕಾಮನ್ನು, ಗುಂಡಿಗೆಯ ಮಾತಾಡಿದರೆ ಗುಂಡಿನ ಧ್ವನಿ ಕೇಳಿಸುವವರ ಜೊತೆ ಪ್ರೇಮಾಲಾಪವೇನು, ಕಾಮಿತಾರ್ಥ ಪ್ರದಾಯನ ಸ್ವಚ್ಛ ಭಾರತದಲ್ಲಿ ಮಗ್ನ, ಕಾಷಾಯ ವಸ್ತ್ರಧಾರಿ ಹೆಜ್ಜೆ ಹೆಜ್ಜೆಗೂ ನಗ್ನ, ಧರ್ಮ ರಕ್ಷಕರಂತೆ ಸ್ಖಲನವೀರರು ಕೂಗುಮಾರಿಗಳು ಇವರೇ ದಂಡಪಿಂಡಗಳು, ಹಾಡುತ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಮಾತು ಮಾತಾ ಅದು ನುಡಿದರೆ ಮುತ್ತಿನ ಹಾರದಂತಿರಬೇಕು ಎಂದರೆ ಚಾರ್ಮೀನಾರು ಸುತ್ತುವವರು, ಯಾರು ಯಾರಿಗೆ ಯಾರು ಹುಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಕ್ಕೆ ಯಾರು ಸಾಕ್ಷಿ, ಕಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಹುಟ್ಟಿದವರು ಹುಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಬೆಳೆದವರು, ಆಣೆ ಪ್ರಮಾಣಕ್ಕೆ ಅವರವ್ವನ ಅಪ್ಪನ ಎಳೆ ತಂದವರು, ಕಾಯಕದ ಮಾತೇ ಇಲ್ಲ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಬರೀ ಕಾಯದ ಕಥೆ, ಕಾಮಕ್ಕೂ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಗುಪ್ತ ಕ್ಯಾಮರಾದ ವ್ಯಥೆ, ಸಾಬರ ಗಲ್ಲಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಸನಾತನಿಯರ ಯಾತ್ರೆ, ಪರಿವರ್ತನೆಯೂ ಒಂದು ಜಾತ್ರೆ, ಸನ್ಯಾಸಿನಿಗೂ ಗೊತ್ತು ಸನ್ಯಾಸಿಗೇನು ಗೊತ್ತು ತಾಜಮಹಲಿನ ಮಹತ್ವ, ಕಮಂಡಲೆ ಸಮುದ್ರವೆಂದುಕೊಳ್ಳುವ ಕುಬ್ಜತ್ವ, ರಥಬೀದಿ ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಹೊರ ಹೋಗಬಾರದಂತೆ ಧರ್ಮ, ಅಷ್ಟಮಠಗಳ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿಗೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಕಟ್ಟು ಹಾಕಲಾಗಿದೆ ಕರ್ಮ, ರಾವಣರ ನೇತೃತ್ವದಲ್ಲಿ ರಾಮನ ಸೇನೆ, ಸೀತೆ ಪದ್ಮಾವತಿಯರು ಇವರ ಸ್ವತ್ತೇನೆ. ಇದು ತಿನ್ನಬಾರದ ಮೀನು, ಕಹಿಯಾಯಿತು ಜೇನು, ಮುಟ್ಟಬಾರದ ಮೈ, ತಟ್ಟಲಾಗದ ಕೈ, ಮೀನು ತಿಂದವರನ್ನು ನೋಡಿ ಮೊಸಳೆ ತಿಂದವರ ಕೇಕೆ, ಬೇಕಿತ್ತ ನಿನಗೆ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಮಂಜುನಾಥ? ಓಕೆ, ಒನ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್. ಓಕೆ, thank you very
much. Thank you very much, Ms. Prithiva. That was brilliant and really sensitive. And now we have Mr. Sarbjot Behel, an architect by profession and a poet by heart. He has been writing since the age of 9 and he writes in Hindustani. So over to you, Mr. Behel.
Thank you. In fact, you just mentioned, Huma, that there are two kinds of genres that patriotism can be conveyed. I'm going to resort to the first one, jingoism, because that is the language which is being spoken now. So eent ka jawab patthar se hi dena chahiye. So I was writing in, you know, subtle and abstract images, and it was not reaching either the common man and to the people who need to get this message. So this poem that I've written is right in the face. Seedhi baat hai, do tuk baat hai. ಔರ್ ಯೇ ಜಲ್ಸೆ ವಾಲಿ ಕವಿತಾ ಹೈ ತೋ ಆಪ್ಕೋ ಫೈವ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ ಲಾಬಿ ಸೆ ಥೋಡಾ ಸಾ ಅಪ್ನೆ ಆಪ್ಕೋ ಮೆಂಟಲಿ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಕರ್ನಾ ಪಡೆಗಾ. ಏಕ ಸಡಕ್ ಛಾಪ್ ಕವಿತಾ ಹೈ ಔರ್ ಇಸ್ ಕವಿತಾ ಕಾ Shirshak, the title of this poem is Nidhadak Sadak Pe Aa Gaya Hai Aam Aadmi. To mujhe ummeed hai ki jis josh se maine ye kavita likhi hai, ye nazm likhi hai, usi josh se ye aap tak pahunche, because that is the purpose of this nazm. Nidhadak Sadak Pe Aa Gaya Hai Aam Aadmi. Azad mulk ka ye ghulam aadmi, har chaukhat pe thokta salam aadmi, bik raha hai kodiyon ke daam aadmi, sar pe uthaye hue ilzaam aadmi, roz lautta hai nakam sare sham aadmi, kul andheron mein gum gum naam aadmi, hai gardish-e ayyam mein tamam aadmi, hai janwar si zindagi bas naam aadmi, magar جھاڑ کر اب گردے علام آدمی سلگتے سینے میں لیے کوہرام آدمی تشنا لبوں پر لے کر پیغام آدمی ایک دوسرے کا ہاتھ لے تھام آدمی تاک پر رکھ کر انجام آدمی پی ہلاہل اور توڑ کر سب جام آدمی ندھڑک سڑک پہ آ گیا ہے عام آدمی. कैसी ये सरकार है, कैसी ये सरकार है, लगा हुआ दरबार है, हर एक दरबारी यहाँ फरमा बरदार है, अंधेर नगरी चौपट राजा, लुटा लुटा बाजार है, चोरी करके सब चोर भाग गए, ये कैसा चौकीदार है. आपके बेंगलोर से भी एक भाग के गए हैं वहां. चोरी करके सब चोर भाग गए, ये कैसा चौकीदार है, देश बड़ा बीमार है, ना रोजी है ना रोजगार है, सत्ता है हफ्ता है और भ्रष्टाचार है, आर है ना पार है, नाव बीच मझधार है, पर दूर कहीं उफक पर उठ रहा गुबार है, पर दूर कहीं उफक पर उठ रहा गुबार है, सिंधु के भाटे में भी आ रहा जवार है, बुझी हुई राख में एक दबा हुआ शरार है, होने को फलक पे एक शोला नमूदार है, लोहा भी गर्म है और चोट भी तैयार है, जल रहा है आसमां और तप रही है ये जमी, ऐसे में अब सोचे क्या अंजाम आदमी, निधड़क सड़क पे आ गया है आम आदमी. ये देश किसी के बाप की जागीर नहीं, ये देश किसी के नाम की जायदाद नहीं, आजाद होकर भी भला क्यों हम आजाद नहीं, हक की लड़ाई में कोई अर्ज नहीं फरियाद नहीं, ये देश किसी एक के मजहब का मोहताज नहीं, ये देश किसी एक के मजहब का मोहताज नहीं, मुझे आम राज चाहिए कोई राम रहीम राज नहीं, मुझे आम राज चाहिए कोई राम रहीम राज नहीं, रथ यात्रा नहीं जिहाद नहीं दंगा नहीं फसाद नहीं, अब और होने देंगे इस देश को हम बर्बाद नहीं, ये देश हमारी धरोहर है, ये देश हमारी धरोहर है, किसी के सर का ताज नहीं, कुछ भी हमें मंजूर नहीं जो पूर्ण स्वराज नहीं, सर पे जो छत नहीं और पेट में अनाज नहीं, तो वोट नहीं सत्ता नहीं कुर्सी नहीं राज नहीं, ना कर हो ना कमल हो, कर हाथ को बोलते हैं, फॉर पीपल हु डोंट नो, कर हाथ को बोलते हैं, ना कर हो ना कमल हो, बस उसूलों पर अमल हो, ना कर हो ना कमल हो, बस उसूलों पर अमल हो, इनके कर कमलों ने है देश हमारा लूटा, इनके कर कमलों ने है देश हमारा लूटा, ये हातिम जो बन रहा है हाकिम है बड़ा झूठा, कान धरो सुखलाल जी और तुम भी सुनो अशरफ मियां, एक दिन जो हो गए एक जहां इस देश के हिंदू मुसलमान, तो रह जाएगी धरी यहां इन हाकिमों की हाकिमी, है खुदा भी इस खल्क में बनाम आदमी, जो आदमी का कर ले एहतराम आदमी, तो फिर अल्लाह आदमी है और है राम आदमी, जो आदमी का कर ले एहतराम आदमी, तो फिर अल्लाह आदमी है और है राम आदमी, निधड़क सड़क पे आ गया है आम आदमी. रोके से रोकेगा ना बहाव इस सैलाब का, रोके से रुकेगा ना भाव इस सैलाब का, है गली गली में गूंज रहा नारा इनकलाब का, है राख में से जी उठा परिंदा सुरखाब का, ये वक्त है हिसाब का, ये वक्त है जवाब का, उछटी हुई नींद का और टूटे हुए ख्वाब का, है हाथ में हमारे अब हक इंतखाब का, गुजर गया जमाना जी हजूर जी जनाब का, तार तार कर देंगे रेशम तेरे नकाब का, छट रहा है फलक से अब अजाब का, है बादलों में से झांक रहा हाला आफताब का, राह में भटक लिए तड़प लिए रो लिए, राह में भटक लिए भीड़ में खो लिए तड़प लिए रो लिए, गम के फसाने हो लिए, है जोश में बदल रहा माहौल था जो मातमी, भाप बन रही है अब अश्रु श्वेत की नबी, निधड़क सड़क पे आ गया है आम आदमी, साडा हक ऐथे रख, साडा हक ऐथे रख, हाथ में खैरात नहीं, तिल तिल करके रोज मरूं ऐसे तो हालात नहीं, मुझे जिंदा जिंदगी चाहिए मौत सी हयात नहीं, कोई मेरा हक छीने किसी के बस की बात नहीं, आजाद खुद मुख्तार हूं मैं किसी से मोहतात नहीं, मेरी कोई जात नहीं मेरी कोई जमात नहीं, मैंने सूरज देख लिया है अब मेरे हिस्से में रात नहीं, ये देश तेरी शतरंज की बिछी हुई बिसात नहीं, और अब मैं वो प्यादा नहीं जिसकी कोई औकात नहीं, एक चाल में खेल बदल दूंगा कोई शय नहीं कोई मात नहीं, जो सर पे कफन बांध लिया तो किस बात की फिर है कभी, तकदीर लिखेगा इस देश की बेनाम आदमी, निधड़क सड़क पे आ गया है आम आदमी। बहुत जलाली हमने चौराहों पे मोमबत्तियां, बहुत सहली ये तुम्हारे ये जुल्म और ये सख्तियां, उफ ये कमबख्तियां तुम्हारी ये बदबख्तियां, खींच लो ये कुर्सियां और तोड़ दो ये तख्तियां, तूफान में ले आए हैं हम भी अपनी कश्तियां, घर घर में शंखनाद है और जाग उठी हैं बस्तियां, एक ठप्पे से मिटा देंगे ये अहम और ये हस्तियां, हम पानी का पानी और दूध का दूध करने आए हैं, जर्रे जर्रे की सोच में बारूद भरने आए हैं, ये निजामे नीरो नेस्तो नाबूद करने आए हैं, भटके हुओं को राह पे मकसूद करने आए हैं, सफेद पोशी को तेरी आलूद करने आए हैं, है तेजाब सा बरसात में और हवा भी है गंदमी, धुल रही है धूल वो आंख पर थी जो जमी, निधड़क सड़क पे आ गया है आम आदमी। आखिरी बंद है इस नज्म का, आम हूं कतई मगर कमजोर नहीं मजबूर नहीं, आम हूं कतई मगर कमजोर नहीं मजबूर नहीं, मगरूर नहीं मखमूर नहीं, सत्ता के नशे में चूर नहीं, सर में कोई सरूर नहीं, किसी फिरके का फितूर नहीं, ताज के लिए ईमान तजदू ये मेरा दस्तूर नहीं, रास्ते का पत्थर हूं मैं कोई कोहे नूर नहीं, चुभ गया जो पाँव में तो मेरा ये कसूर नहीं, ये नूर तेरे फानूस का हरगिज मुझे मंजूर नहीं, मैंने शमा जला ली है अब मेरी कबा बे नूर नहीं, माना कि मेरी जात में वो शानो शौकत शौर नहीं, इट इज नॉट ए सोफिस्टिकेटेड पोएम एट ऑल, माना कि मेरी जात में वो शानो शौकत शौर नहीं, पर निकल पड़े हैं सड़क पर तो दिल्ली भी अब दूर नहीं, जो अकेला था वो बन गया आवाम आदमी, अब पाही लेगा मंजिलो मुकाम आदमी, निधड़क सड़क पे आ गया है आम आदमी। शुक्रिया।
That was beautiful and most energetic, Mr. Behel. Thank you very much. And we have now Mandrakanta Sen. And she writes in Bangla, a poet and an activist. She lives in Calcutta. And she has 30 books to her credit. She was a medical student and she opted out in her final year to pursue her interest of writing poetry. So, Mandrakanta. Yeah.
Thank you very much. I just want to talk to you And I take this advantage of this stage to say something, to tell something. And if you can, if you like, you can accept this as my poetry, as my poem. The word patriot keeps changing its color, and if the poet is conscious enough, her writings show the hue. I must say I am a politically conscious poet, or has become one lately, keeping my love songs alive in a parallel stream. That is another thing, but let me talk about the patriotic aspect of my poetry. For now, to me, being a patriot carries a whole new meaning. In this country, as we all know, we are being judged by what we say, what we eat, which God we worship. In every step, you have to match your life according to state-defined ideology and lifestyle to be recognized as a patriot. This patriotism is a totally politically motivated one. It is intolerant, it is aggressive, even many a times it is even violent. My poetry is a protest against this wrong patriotism of which we are all victims. Our state is in danger, a grave one. Now, what is a country? What is a country? The state ruled by some political party, or is it the nation? If the answer is the second one, one must admit that our country is truly endangered. We have to rescue our state from its own hands, from itself. Our nation needs that badly. People need it badly. But the fact is, some are not even conscious about how grave the situation is and how much grave it will become in the near future. It's the intellectuals, like poets and writers, who should tell them about this, make them alert enough to save themselves from an even worse future. Today, patriotism means war at the border, but the true patriotism is the war within, against poverty, against caste system. True patriotism means making my country free from intolerance, from fundamentalism, from discrimination amongst class, caste, language, and gender. That and only that would make my country truly independent. I write about all this, I raise my voice, at least I try to. I'm quite vocal about it. That sometimes means I'm at gunpoint. I get regular threats of murder and gang rape in my message box. I'm a true patriot. So after Dadri incident and brutal murder of Gavin Pansare, Narendra Dabhulkar, M.M. Kalburgi, I return my Sahitya Akademi Golden Jubilee Award. Because I'm a true patriot, I may even be accused of sedition, but I know I am with people and people know I am with them. I travel extensively all over West Bengal to work for people, to stand by them whenever necessary. And during my journey or after I come back, I sit down and write. I know it is expected that a poet or a poem should be poetic. Well, I may not be like that all the time. I don't believe in art for art's sake, poetry for poetry's sake. It must have some deeper message, bigger commitment to the masses. That is the call of the hour. I haven't at all abandoned poems about love, about nature, poems with subtle symbols, signals, tangent appeals. But if you ask me to talk about the poet and the patriot, I would just say I want to be my nation's conscience. That is pretty, in a pretty straight, direct, and clear manner. I'm just committed to common people of my country, and my poetry aspires to become the voice of the masses. I can't say how good a poet I am. I can't say how good a poet I am, but I can boast that I am a true patriot.
দিকে দিকে থ্যাংক ইউ দিকে দিকে শুধু একই প্রতিবাদ শুনি কোথায় পালাবি মানবিকতার খুনি রক্তে রক্তে লাল হয়ে গেল হৃদি নৃশংস এই পীড়নে সেই শহীদি কথা বলে ওঠে অন্তরাত্মা থেকে কথা বলে ওঠে অন্তরাত্মা থেকে তুমি একা নও তোমার মৃত্যু দেখে আজকে আমরা হয়েছি তো একজোট আজকে আমরা হয়েছি তো একজোট ও আমার ভাই এবার গর্জে ওঠ ও আমার বোন এবার গর্জে ওঠ ও আমার সাথী এবার গর্জে ওঠ ও আমার দেশ এবার গর্জে ওঠ টুডে এভরিওয়ান ইজ শাউটিং দ্য সেম প্রোটেস্ট To win the war, everywhere there is such an unrest. Our bosoms are red with blood. Our bosoms are red with blood, bearing this terrible torture. The martyrs hit back hard. They speak up from within our souls. They speak up from within our souls. It's your death that inspires us to struggle for the same goal. Now we are united. Now we are united. No one can break us anymore. This is the time. Come on, friend, make the mighty roar. Come, my brother, make the mighty roar. Come, my sister, make the mighty roar. Come, my friend, make the mighty roar. Come on, my country, make the final mighty roar. কাব্য লিখে কিছু হয় কাব্য লিখে কিছু হয় সে তো শুধু যন্ত্রণার খাতা নির্যাতিত সময়ের বেদনা মুখর খতিয়ান তবু তাকে হাতিয়ার করে তুলতে কিবা ক্ষতি আন যেখানে কপাল জুড়ে প্রতিবাদ লিখেছে বিধাতা না গো না বিধাতা নয় না গো না বিধাতা নয় এ তো শুধু মানুষের দায় পথে নামো আজ আর লুকিয়ে থেকো না ঘরে 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 বাইরে মানুষের প্রাণ যাচ্ছে নিছক বেঘরে আমি শুধু ঘরে বসে পদ্য লিখছি হায় তবু জানি এই লেখা মানুষের কণ্ঠে দিলে স্বর কাব্য আর প্রতিবাদ মিলেমিশে যাবে পরস্পর কাব্য আর প্রতিবাদ মিলেমিশে যাবে পরস্পর হোয়াট ইজ দ্য পয়েন্ট অফ রাইটিং পোয়েমস What's the point of writing poems? It's just a register of pain, an account of anguished hours. Still, we can use them as weapons. We can use them as weapons and then see how our foreheads are smeared with fate of ours. No, God has written our fate. No, God has written our fate. It's us who have done this. Time has come. Take to the road. Don't hide your faces. At your home and out, there is no peace. And I am only writing daring poems and essays. But I know if and when these words can become people's voice. But I know if and when these words can become people's voice, poetry and protest both will become people's own spontaneous choice. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Vandakanta. I'm totally mesmerized by your passionate poetry. We have now Mr. Sandeep Bhutoria. He's a culturist, a social activist, very active in the art and cultural world. And he has many initiatives to his credits, including Akhar, Loves, and Kalam.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Let me compliment by the festival directors and the organizer for having this poetry festivals and with such a nice session. I have been given the dice when the time bomb is saying zero, so I don't have any minute to speak. So bear with me for 5 minutes. As the session suggests, the poet and the patriot, the definitions keep changing. Like poets, their poetry also have a life cycle of their own, often supported and do manipulated by politics. As my co-guests at the dais have shared various interests, I'm really impressed by my friend from Kerala who said that the poetry is an expression of individual. It's not an expression of a citizen or society. why my friend from Punjab has said that Aam Aadmi is, you know, Awam and we can go to Delhi. So of course, every poetry, every word has different meaning. In this context, I would like to give three different examples here. Any poetry written at a particular historical context, like freedom struggle, rooted in a particular geographical region or the time frame of that region, a fresh lease of patriotism for years to come. But also there are poems in our history that transcend barriers of times and geography with their universal message. Let me elaborate. Allama Muhammad Iqbal, 1877 to 1938. Poet, philosopher, politician. Regarded as having inspired Tehreek-e-Pakistan or the Pakistani movement, he is considered the ideological founder of Pakistan as well. Consider his Tarane-e-Hind or Sare Jahan Se Acha, widely used in India as a patriotic song. The poem was published in the weekly journal Itihad on 16th August 1904, publicly recited by Iqbal the following year at the Government College in Lahore. The song, An Ode to Undivided Hindustan, was later published in 1924 in the Urdu book Bange Dara. It's quickly become an anthem of opposition that time to the whole society against British Raj. 6 years later, we see the same Iqbal transformation when he wrote Tarana-e-Milli, or anthem of the religious community, a patriotic song for children. It was composed in the same manner and rhythm as Sare Jahan Se Acha, but renounced much of sentiment of the earlier song. The sixth stanza of Sare Jahan Se Acha, which is often quoted as proof of Iqbal's secular outlook, Majhab Nahi Sikata, Aapas Mein Bair Rakhna, Hindi Hai Hum Watan Ke, Hindo Sata Hamara. Contrastingly significantly, with the first stanza of Tarane-e-Milli 1910, which he writes, and I quote, Sino Arab Hamara, Hindustan Hamara, Muslim Hai Hum Watan Ke, Hai Sara Jahan Hamara. Central Asian Arabi are ours, Hindustan is ours. We are Muslim, the whole world is now our homeland. Iqbal's worldview had now changed. It had become both global and Islamic. Instead of singing of Hindustan, our homeland, the new song proclaimed by Iqbal, our homeland is the whole world. 2 decades later, in his presidential address to the Muslim League annual conference in Allahabad in 1930, he supported a separate national state in the Muslim majority areas of the subcontinent, and that time the idea had inspired the creation of Pakistan. With time, the song has remained popular, but only in India. An abridged, reduced version is sung and played frequently as a patriotic song and as a marching song of the Indian Armed Forces as well. Sare Jahan Se Acha become all the more popular with time. Mahatma Gandhi used to sing it often. Pandit Ravi Shankar Ji gave a fast-paced music to Sare Jahan Se Acha to make it more inspiring in impact, which was adopted as the official quick march of the Indian Armed Force. Later, Lata Mangeshkar Ji recorded it in a different tune with stanza 1st, 3rd, 4th, omitting 5th and 6th of the poem, because an unofficial national song of India. It is played during the Republic Day and Indian Independence Day and the school with great patriotic fervor. So a poet changed his stand, but his original poem continued to be source of officially endorsed inspiration for a vast number of people in the country. While others choose to ignore it, in contrast, the poet's Tarana-e-Milli is hardly remembered by the masses. Poetry, as in written words, has its own appeal irrespective of the poet's political leaning, whatsoever it may be. In present days, the patriotic fervor of Sare Jahan Se Acha depends on which side of geography you are in. The poem Sare Jahan Se Acha, Hum Bulbulen Hain Kisi Ki Ye Gulista Hamara, Gurbat Mein Hai Agar Hum Rehta Hai Dil, Watan Mein Samjho Watan Hamare Bhi Dil Hai. All these things, if I read the whole poet, the sixth stanza states, Majhab Nahi Sikhata Aapas Mein Bair Rakhna, Hindi Hai Hum Watan Ke, Hindo Sata Hamara. Religion does not teach us to bear animosity among ourselves. We are of Hind, our homeland is Hindustan. And if you see the same poetry, he writes, Yunan O Misr O Roma, Sab Mit Gaye Jahan Se, Ab Tak Magar Hai Baagi, नामो निशा हमारा कुछ बात है कि हस्ती मिटती नहीं हमारी सदियों रहा है दुश्मन दौरे जहां हमारा. सेकंड एग्जांपल आफ्टर इकबाल आई कैन गिव द बंकिम चटर्जी एंड वंदे मातरम. वंदे मातरम इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट पॉपुलर पोइम्स ऑफ अवर टाइम, बट इट वाज चेंज्ड टू सूट अवर नीड्स. only two stanzas was adopted by the Congress. Now very few people, including I didn't know when I was doing research, knew anything beyond these two stanzas of this poem. As I said, patriotic poem has its lives of its own, depending on the geographical locations and time the patriotic poems has been written. Bankim Chandra ji wrote it first in a small town called Chunchura in West Bengal around 1876 and published it in his book Anand Math in 1882. Tagore sang it at the Calcutta Congress session in 1986. Rishi Aurobindo translated into English, it becomes a rallying cry and slogan against the British Raj in Bengal then. British banned Anand Math and made the recital of a poem song a crime. Mahatma Gandhi kept it close to his heart and said, Jai Hind should never replace Vande Mataram. Lala Lajpat Rai started a magazine by the name Vande Mataram. In 1907, Bhikaji Kama put Vande Mataram at the center of the first version of Tiranga or Indian national flag in Germany. A part of the poem was adopted in 1937 as national song. The entire song was not selected to respect the sentiment of non-Hindus that time. Jinnah opposed this song. In 1950, Dr. Rajendra Prasad ensured that Vande Mataram shall be honored equally with Janaganamana and shall have equal status with it. Now we have Vande Mataram as a rallying cry, more of a slogan, but nevertheless, it still evokes strong patriotic feeling in majority of Indians. So political manipulation or official endorsement of poem often keeps alive the patriotic flavor. And when poems become songs, it can have an altogether different impact. The third example, which Ms. Huma Mirza has said during her introduction about the Tagore's, let my country awake, where mind is without fear and the head held high, where knowledge is free, where the word has been broken up into fragments and more narrow domestic walls. I would like to end by saying the sheer appeal of free thought has an universal appeal. Also, the poet in the end mentions, let my country awake. He alludes to India, but not name any particular country in this poet. That's why this poetry has become so popular all over the world. Because being in that geographical location, you can think, let my country awake. It's not that let my country awake is only for India. It, wherever you are, whichever country you sing, let my country awake. Ramchandra Narayan Ji Dwivedi, popular in India as Kavi Pradeep, who wrote more than 1500 plus poems and songs for the Hindi cinema, has written a songs like Ae Mere Watan Ke Logo, had said, and I finish by this quote, nobody can make you patriotic. It's in your blood. It is how you bring it out to serve the country that makes you different, no poetry. Thank you.
That was brilliant and thoroughly analyzed, Mr. Bhatoria. Thank you very much. In the end, I would like to recite two couplets of my father, Khalilur Rahman Azmi, and which beautifully resonates this undying spirit of progress and change. Barha dast sitamgar ko qalam humne kiya. Barha dast sitamgar ko qalam humne kiya. Barha chaak andhere ki qaba humse hui. Humne utne hi sareerah jalaye hai chiragh. Jitni bargashta zamane ki hawa humse hui. We severed the hands of tyrant, times galore, the vestments of darkness we tore. We ignited as many lamps along the road, upon us as many storms time bestowed. Before I end and we go into the final music performance, I would like to give a big round of applause to the Bangalore Poetry Festival organizers for giving us two phenomenal days of non-stop, unadulterated, pure feast of soul food, which we relish to our heart's content. Thank you and shukriya.
Thank you, Huma, and thanks to the panelists for this wonderful session. I don't think there could have been a better session wrapping up the Bengaluru Poetry Festival. 2 days of lots of poetry from all over the world of different languages.